Hi guys, I'm very happy to be back with another video today, and this video is going to be really helpful to you if you are planning to buy a new fridge anytime soon or later, or if you already have one and looking for some organizing tips and ideas. Yes, you got it right. This video is going to be an A to Z of refrigerators. In this video, I will be talking about some technical aspects of refrigerators in India and few tips to consider before buying one, and along with my refrigerator tour and tips for organizing yours. So let's get started.
Refrigerator is one such invention that certainly has changed our lifestyle. Refrigeration is a technique wherein the food items are stored and maintained in certain temperature to lower the formation of bacteria. As we know, refrigerator keeps the food cold. The words cold and warm are relative to each other. That is, absence of heat is cold. In simple terms, refrigerator is an appliance that helps in keeping the food items cold by eliminating heat. Let us now try to understand the working of refrigerator. A refrigerator works based mainly on three technical aspects: compression, condensation, and evaporation. This entire process is termed as vapor compression cycle. It is almost 200 years old. It's not phasing out anytime soon. Before getting into VC, let us try to understand a small concept here. Hot and cold stuff are placed next to each other. The heat flows from hotter stuff to colder stuff. This is second law of thermodynamics. There are four components in a vapor compression cycle: compressor, condenser, expansion or throttle valve, evaporator, along with refrigerant. Refrigerant is a special gas or fluid that is used in vapor compression cycle process of refrigerators. Without refrigerant, refrigerators or any other freezing technology is not possible. Refrigerants like CFC, HCFC, HFC has a high potential to contribute for global warming and also for ozone layer depletion. On the other hand, HC and HFO are considered to be safer and they are environmental friendly as they have zero impact on ozone layer and global warming. Now let us try to understand the vapor compression cycle process. It is a five-step process. The compressor constricts the refrigerant vapor, raising its pressure and temperature. The hot gas in the coils of the condenser get converted into liquid. Now this liquid at high pressure flows into the throttle valve. Refrigerant absorbs the heat inside the fridge when it flows through the evaporator coil, cooling down the air inside the fridge. Refrigerant evaporates and flows back to the compressor, where the cycle starts all over again. Now let us understand little of refrigerator's history. In 1700 BC, William Cullen first documented public demo of artificial refrigeration. In 1930s, refrigerators with vapor compression system, freons, were introduced. Later we had some design changes. Freezers were introduced with bottom cooling. In 1980s, focus shifted more on energy efficiency, and the current progress is to make the refrigerator more smarter, and in future environmental friendly design are on the rise. Types of refrigerators. Single door refrigerators. Capacity of 150 to 250 liters. Direct cool, economical, ample freezer space, digital auto defrost, suitable for couples and small families. Double door. 240 to 500 liters frost free, larger freezer space, energy efficient. Most shelves are made up of toughened glass, suitable for 4 to 5 people. Further classified as top mount and bottom mount. Triple door, 240 to 350 liters, frost-free, toughened glass shelf, larger separate veggie drawers, usually at the bottom, suitable for couples with two kids. Side by side, 550 to 850 liters, frost-free, ample sections, ample space for veggies, toughened glass shelves, few have waterized dispensers. Innovative technologies in household refrigerators. Conversion facility. The normal fridge freezer ratio is 80:20, as vegetarian population are slightly higher in India. These are the variants where the ratio is 70:30. This type is useful for non-vegetarian population as they tend to use the freezer box more. So in short, this technology helps you to convert your freezer into a fridge and your fridge into a freezer. If you are traveling or just one person at your home, you can very well convert your freezer box as refrigerator. So the main advantage here is you're increasing the storage capacity of your refrigerator. Inverter technology. Inverter technology works on the simple principle of optimizing the power of the compressor unit. In normal refrigerator, compressor alternates between on and off position at regular intervals. This can consume higher amount of electricity as compressor works at single speed. This inverter technology allows the compressor to work consistently at different speed and deliver the necessary output depending upon the cooling load. So the advantages of this inverter technology is that it decreases the energy consumption and thus improving the lifespan of your refrigerator. Overcome power cuts. It's a new technology, keeps the contents cool and fresh even during power cuts up to 2 to 7 hours. Of course, the price is on the higher side. Environmental friendly. Using refrigerants that are eco-friendly has a greater advantage over the other refrigerators. BEE star rating system. BEE stands for Bureau of Energy Efficiency that rates the efficiency of the refrigerator based on the energy consumption. The ratings are in the form of stars, with 5 star being the most efficient. Now let's draw the conclusion. Every rupee should be carefully spent whenever you bring home a new appliance. A little bit of research in the initial stage can save you a lot of money, and this is what everyone is looking for. So try understanding a requirement and study the features available to make a correct choice. So coming up next is my refrigerator tour with few organizing tips. Stay tuned. So this is Samsung Twin Cooling Plus 324 liters 3 star inverter frost free double door refrigerator. Let us quickly get into my refrigerator top organization. The first thing you will see is a big pouch containing some Ziploc covers along with all my warranties and user manuals of various appliances, below which I have placed a garbage bag. Adding greens makes it elegant, so here it is, my artificial bamboo plant. I've kept 2 banana cases. Banana cases are lightweight, easy to carry. Multiple small perforation facilitate ventilation, thus preventing premature ripening. Sturdy mechanism to keep them closed. There is a sponge with a scrub pad, few aprons and empty spaces you see all for kitchen towels. Now let us move to the side pockets. That's my wallet, grocery list for the current month and few bills for my reference. Here you will see a cylinder book and few bills along with some chalk pens of different shades, chalkboard stickers and a whitener. Here I have kept a shopping bag along with a notepad and a blue pen. Behind this pocket you will see a magnetic hook where I hang my apron when I am using it. Later I will shift them to my organizer you saw in the top. I have switched off my fridge before showing it to you all. Using handle covers will protect your fridge handles from stains as we use them much often while cooking. Let us begin with the first tray. In the extreme right you will find a butter box inside which there will be a salted and unsalted butter. Next to it is a pullout tray. Inside this there is some paneer, cheese, cream and a stainless steel box with some paneer again for my lunch. Next to it is a milk tray. This is a pullout organizer and I have stored peeled garlic pods in them. Here I have placed the dosa batter over a pullout tray which is highly convenient for cleaning. This side of my fridge is devoted for leftovers. These are glass containers with lid and they are stackable too. I have lined every tray with anti-slip mats. Let us quickly move to the next tray. Here is some curd in a glass container with a wooden spoon. Next to it are the 2 organizers with lid and along with 3 small bins in them. In one I have stored chilies, curry leaves and cilantro. In the other I have stored ginger, mint and lemon. I have covered curry leaves, coriander, lemon and mint leaves with kitchen towel just to improve their shelf life. The last shelf has 3 pull-out baskets. In the first I have kept all my dips like ketchup and mayonnaise, and the second one is for coconut. The third one is for baking stuffs like cocoa powder, baking powder, essence, dry yeast, etc. This is a big box for storing veggies and fruits. Here I have placed a basket over which veggies are kept in mesh bags usually, but now I am slowly shifting to these cotton kind of potli bags just to avoid plastics. I have lined this basket with anti-slip mat and also below the box just to avoid scratches as we move the box much frequently. Now let us quickly check how I have organized my fridge side trays. In this tray, I have kept all the masalas I seldom use like bay leaves, kasuri methi, rajma masala, garam masala and tea masala. If they are not in the original cartons, I make sure to write their expiry on the packing. Next to it, I have stored 2 stainless steel boxes. In the bottom, I have kept some elachis and in the top, I have stored some saffron. I also keep milkmaid in the same tray. Since I don't store eggs, I have used the egg trays for storing some chocolates and biscuits in mesh bags. Also, I have labeled the trays. In the bottle tray, I have kept some Glucon-D chocolate mousse and milkshake along with a juice carton and water bottles. Do not keep your fridge door open for a long time if you want to cut down on your electricity charges. Do not overstuff your refrigerator. Please provide enough space between the things you store. Always store dairy products in the top tray. Do not mix vegetables and fruits. Always use cotton bags for storing them. Always try wrapping lemon, coriander leaves, mint leaves with kitchen towel for longer shelf life. Do secure your fridge handles with handle covers. Make sure to clean every tray in your refrigerator with shelf liners for easy and quick cleaning. Also keep a practice to clean the outer area, that is the handles in the door area, every day with a microfiber cloth. Weekly once, reorganization and cleaning of your refrigerator is recommended. Now let's see what's in the freezer. Above the cool pad is my frozen food basket where I usually keep ice creams, frozen peas and corn. Next to it is few medicines in the box. Below I've kept some karvepalai podi, homemade lemon pickle and ginger paste. I've also kept a gasket. Next to it is a movable ice tray. Now let us explore the side trays of my freezer. So here I have kept a mixed fruit jam, some cashews, almonds, dry raisins and pickle, below which I have kept some sliced watermelons in a ziplock along with Szechuan chutney and instant soup sachet. This refrigerator has got digital inverter technology with 10-year warranty on the compressor. The BEE rating is 3 star and its electricity consumption will be 260 units per year. You can see a twin cooling panel in the center. Here I can convert my freezer as fridge or just turn it off. We can also set our desired temperature for refrigerator. The preferred temperature will be 0 degrees Celsius to 3 degrees Celsius. You will see various notes every day in my fridge. Here I have stuck the unfilled grocery items. I strike them out once they are added to my pantry jars. And you also get to see a lot of magnets in my fridge. And here is a list for your reference.
I hope you liked the video, guys. If you did, please like the video, share the video with your friends, and do not forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.